Hey there, this is Josh at TechPodge. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I'll give you a short but complete video tutorial on Adobe Rush. This will help you to get the best results out of the app right from the start because it has a ton to offer, and I'll cover all the essential features. And if you like my approach to quickly learning Adobe programs, then please subscribe to my channel where you'll find more short tutorials. So what is Adobe Rush? Well, basically, it's another app for content video creators. It's suited for people on the go or in a rush who want a simple tool to quickly create and edit videos. And I'd recommend Rush to anyone who wants to quickly and easily upload video content to social media and is just getting started with video editing. So if you're just getting into video editing, this is really a great tool to start with. So let's take a look at the webpage where I'm at right now. And by the way, if we scroll down, you can see you can sync across all these different devices, which is important because you want to pick up wherever you left off. So if you're working on your phone and then you go home, you can work on your iPad or you can work on your desktop. And of course, you can use Apple or Android phones. And you can start for free. So that's really nice to know. You can simply download it onto your phone or on your desktop and begin working right away. Or you can join up with the Adobe Express program, and that comes with a monthly plan. Or you can join for the whole Adobe app subscription plan, which is what I would actually recommend because that offers you the best value. Once we start Rush, we'll see the app landing page. And this is the page that you'll see just before you begin editing a video. So this is the app landing page where you're gonna select a previous project you've been working on to continue working. As you can see, I've got several, or you can go over here and you can create a new project. Let's create a new project. I'll click on this button. In the second page, I can now give it a name. So now that I've given the project a name, I can now select the media. So I can go over here and you can see from my video folder, I can select the media that I want to bring in. And it is basically added to the timeline, the order in which it is selected. So if I give you a few examples here, 1, 2, 3, 4, these clips are going to be added to the video timeline in this order. And I can also select other media. So if I go over to pictures here, I can grab some random pictures here just to make the point. You can see it's now continued at 5, 6, 7, and 8. And you can see here it's all being added to this timeline down below here. Now, if you don't know the exact order, don't worry about it too much because you can always adjust it once you begin editing your video. But if I go back here, again, I can add in some more video if I wanted to, just to make that point, I'll add that one. So now you can see I've got 9 different clips added, some videos and some photographs. And now I'm gonna go down here to the bottom right and click Create. Now that I've opened this project in the Adobe Rush editor, you can see all of my media on the timeline below. So this is what we call the timeline in Adobe Rush. And you can see all the media has been added to that timeline in the order in which I selected it. So here's the first one, second, third, and so on. And by the way, you can easily navigate between these different clips by simply clicking the up or down arrow, which is really handy to know. Okay, simply click up or down and you can navigate through all of these clips. Now let's continue with a quick tour of the interface. Let's now take a look at the timeline edit features. In the bottom left-hand corner, you can see these are the timeline edit features. So let's start with the playhead, actually. So I'm gonna click on the playhead. I'm gonna drag it forward at the 30-second mark. And you can see here, wherever I drop the playhead, this blue line here, this is where I'm going to insert my edit, or this is where I can click the play button and it'll play from that point. Now, let's say I wanna clip out this first part. There's a couple different ways that I can do that. I can simply go over to either end. For example, I'm gonna get this little yellow arrow here. And if I hover over this end, or this end, I'm gonna get the same arrow. It only appears at the ends, by the way, and that's where you can actually simply drag the clip. So if I wanna simply click here, I can now drag forward, and you can see the time changing within the frame, and this is actually going to edit out that part of the clip. Now, I can also undo that by simply clicking on it again and dragging in the opposite direction. So now I've got the whole clip back to where I was. Again, I can do the same thing at the opposite end, and I can do that with any clip by simply clicking on it, and now you can see the arrows will appear at either end. So you simply click and drag. Now let's say, for example, I want to edit out this frame right here. So what I can do is I can simply put my playhead there, click there, and now my playhead appears there, and now I'm going to simply drag over here, and now I can simply click on this little scissors icon, and now it's actually split the clip in two. Now I'm going to go over here and I'm going to put the scissors there again, click there, and now you can see this has been selected. So now I can simply delete this because I've cut it here and here. So now it's gone. I can also duplicate a clip by simply clicking on it and going over here to click the plus icon. And now you can see it's duplicated that. I can also expand the audio. So if I want here, I can click here, expand audio, and now I've got the whole audio. So this is important to know about. This is typically the first thing I do when I first begin editing a timeline. I click on that and now it expands the audio. And if I want to separate it, I can do that as well. I can right click now and I can click separate audio. So now you've got a separate audio track that you can begin working with. And lastly, if I go down here, I can click on the control tracks icon in the bottom left hand corner. And once I click on that, you can see now this is going to open up all the tracks. So in Rush, I can have up to 4 video tracks. And to prove that, I'll show you real quick. If I right click here, I'm going to actually duplicate this. And now I can actually drag this up top here. All you do is simply drag it on top of the other. And now you've got a video sitting on top of a video. And you may wonder, well, why do you want to do that? Well, for example, if I select this one, I can go back top here. I can select this again now, and you can see I get these lines around. And now you can say I can scale this. So I'm going to scale this down so you can see I can have a video within a video playing if I want to show 2 videos at the same time, for example. Also, you can have up to 3 audio tracks. So also notice that to the left of each track that you've got 3 additional features. So for example, you can hide it, okay? You can also mute it, or you can also lock it to prevent any further changes. On the right-hand side, I've got some additional features, and these features will be used to refine my clips. So if I click on the T, it's going to open the graphics pane where I can customize my graphics, and I'll come back to this in just a second. Below there, I've got the effects button, which allows me to add in transitions and do a pan and zoom. Below there, I've got color correction, for example, cinematic. Below there, I've got speed, so I can slow a clip down or I can speed it up. And below there, I've got audio. So this is where I can adjust my audio and bounce the sound, for example. And below there, finally, I've got transform. So this is where I can actually crop my video. Next, I'll show you how to add and edit graphics. So if you click on the T button, you can now click on the plus sign here to add a graphic, and you can see all your graphics will open over here. If you want to see more, you can simply click on this drop-down arrow, and you'll get your titles, transition graphics, okay, transition graphics or overlays or any that you have saved. So it's all going to show here on this drop-down arrow. Now, if you want to actually pick something, all you need to do is actually select it. Okay, I'm going to select this title graphic, and then I'm simply going to drag it in, click and drag it into the timeline. I want to start right about here at, say, the 15 or 20 second mark. I'm going to drop it, and now you can see it's actually been installed. So I'm going to click on this again because I want to edit the graphic now. So I need to click on it and select it, and now I can begin editing it. And you can see all these features are now open over here under the T button. The T is for template. So now I can edit this template. And if I go over here, you can see I can edit the font. I can add the font style. I can add the font size. So let's say I want to make this bigger. I want to make this bigger. So I'm going to drop and drag that to, say, this size. And I want the font color to be black. I want it to be easier to read. So I'm going to make that black and click OK. And now you can see it's black. It's a bit too large, so make that a bit smaller. But you can see how easy it is to add things and edit. And if you want to, you can also click within the panel itself to change the scaling. So I'm going to click here within this panel, and now you can see I can actually select it and move it around. So let's say I want to move it, you know, further down. Okay, I can now actually move it further down, and now it's at the bottom. And if I double click in here again, I can actually change the name. So let's add this, let's add TechPodge. So once I click into the font, I can actually begin typing it, and now you can see there it is. Next, I'll show you how to add in transitions. So simply go to the effects button, click it, and now you can see all the transitions that are available to you. So you can even adjust these. For example, I simply click where I want the transition to appear. As you can see, it's placed here, my playhead. So now I'm going to go over here and click wipe right. And now you can see the transition is placed here. You can see this little gray box appear right there. I can click none again if I want to remove it, or I can select another one. And I can even adjust the timing. Once I've selected it, I can even change the timing. 0.50 is about right, but you can make it up to 3 seconds long and short as 0.20. So very easy to do. I've also got transition graphics available too. So if I go back over here to the plus icon, click that, and then click graphics, you can see now I've got transition graphics here. If you don't see it, simply click the plus, the drop down arrow, and you'll see others. But here you go, transition graphics. If I select one of these and then click add, the transition graphic will now apply there. But to change this and to modify this, I actually need to click into it. Now, once again, you're going to see those little arrows on either end. Now I simply can click and drag it on either end to make it shorter or longer. I want to make this much shorter, so I'm going to keep adjusting this. I'm going to delete the other one, select it, and click delete. And now if I click play, you can see how it will work. At the third button down, you can see this is where you can change the color effects of your clips. So if you click there, you can see these are all the built-in presets. So cinematic, for example, or cyan, but I'm going to keep it at none. And now at the fourth button down, you can see these are your speed effects. So you can see by default, the entire clip has been selected wherever I had the playhead. In this case, you can actually see the playhead is basically in the middle. You can also see that here. If you look very closely, you can see a little white dot there. And this is where you would change the speed if you want to speed it up or slow it down. So for example, in this case, I wanted to make it 3 times faster. So I'm gonna go in here and basically drag that to where I want to go. You can also go in here and type it in here. If you find that difficult to slide, simply go in and type it in. And now it's gonna be 3 times faster than the rest of the, than the other clips. So I click play there, you can see how fast it's gonna go. So it's basically 300% faster. If you want to adjust your video audio, then simply click on the audio button here, and now you've got all the features that you need to adjust your audio. So you can see here that this first clip is selected, but if I want my settings to apply to all of these clips, then I can simply click and drag, and now I can select all of them. Or I can do a Control A, and that will select all of them. Over here, you can see you can adjust the volume. By default, it's set to 50, but if I wanted to, I can adjust this up, say, just a few percentage points to 60, and now that will apply to all of them. I can also mute them, or under the advanced features, I've got an auto volume feature, which will basically automatically keep all the sounds basically near the same sound, okay? And now below that, you've got balance sound, which will actually balance your highs and your lows. You can reduce background noise here, reduce echo here if you've got an echo, and enhance speech if you need to. You can also crop your videos. Simply click on this button here, and now you've got all of these different features. So for example, I could change the horizontal position of my film, I could change the vertical position of it, and I can even rotate it like so. And I can even change the opacity. And if I want to crop it, simply go down below here, and now you can see you can crop it from the top, from the bottom, from the left, or from the right. So now's the fun part. Once you've finished editing, you're ready to share. So go to the top here and click on the second tab here, share. And you're going to see that you've got a couple different options. You can save it to your local drive first, which is typically what I do, or you can sign into any of these channels here, YouTube for example, sign in, and now simply select your settings and click export. Now I'm going to save it to my local first because I prefer to do it that way. I'm going to give this file a name, then I'm going to go down here and select the right preset. And this is important under advanced settings, by the way. Simply scroll down, for example, in my case, it's going to be YouTube 1080 Full HD. And then I'm simply going to go over here and click export. And now you can see it is actually rendering. And this does take a few minutes, so you'll need to just give it a couple. But thanks for watching. I really liked delivering this video and making it. It was a bit of work. So if you enjoyed it, please give me a like. And please don't forget to subscribe. So I'm going to produce many more videos to quickly get you up to speed on all of the Adobe applications. So hope to see you soon. And thanks. Bye.